Hello friends, we are continuing our discussion of crash test 1. Look at question number 5-8. 5-8 says that aqueous solution of a protein has osmotic pressure 3.8 mm. Right, at 300 Kelvin. Concentration is given 1/49.26%, that is W by V, weight upon volume. We have to find out the molar mass of protein. Alright, this is the question. Now see, we know pi is equal to MRT. Pi is equal to MRT. Okay. So this is 3.8 is the osmotic pressure in mm divided by 760. We converted this into atmosphere. Now concentration or molarity is 1/49.26. All right, it is mass by volume, means this is actually mass. All right, in 100 ml of solution, so this is volume of solution, that is in 0.0 liter. All right, molarity, that is not molarity, concentration is given in grams per liter, grams per 100 ml. 100 ml is converted to liter, so it is 0.1, and this is the molar mass of that protein. And R is 0.0821 and temperature is mentioned, it is 300. So if you solve this portion, you get M equal to 1000. Alright, question number 5-8. Look at question number 5-9. At question number 5-9. We are given an aqueous solution of non-volatile solute is such that the vapor pressure is 25% lesser than that of water at same temperature. 25% less. Molality of solution. Alright, question number 5-9. Look at question number 5-9. We have this relation P0A minus PA upon PA. Now you should be careful. Normally we use P0A. But this formula gives you the accurate value. So it is better we use PA. This is molar mass of the solvent. This is molar mass of solvent, that is water. So it is 18. Now, since it says the vapor pressure is reduced by 25%. So if P0A is 100, PA becomes 75. It is reduced by 25%. So PA is 75. So this is 100 minus 75 is 25/75. Alright, 25/75, and this is 1000 by 18. So 25/75 is 3, 1 by 3, 18 into 3 is 54. So it is 1000 by 54. Molality is 1000 by 54. Correct answer is first option, 59. Alright, 59, fourth option is correct, 1000. I'm sorry, 50. Is this 59? It is 1000. No, it is 59. This one, it is 1000 by 54. I'm sorry, it is 1000 by 54. Question number 59, first option. Question number 60. Look at question number 60. It says Sn(Sn2) positive, and then copper single positive and copper. So E0 of copper is given, but you should be careful. This is oxidation potential. Copper is getting converted to copper is getting converted to copper single positive, and this is Sn(Sn2) positive. So this is basically not E0 value. All right, this is oxidation potential, and we have to find out this Sn2 positive upon copper single positive to the power 3 and to the power 6 values we have to find out. So if you calculate E0 cell, since copper is on right hand side, it is cathode. So E0 of cathode minus E0 of anode, that is 10. So we have changed the sign, because in this formula we always put reduction potential values. Alright, so this is 0.54 minus 0.16, that is equal to 0.7. Now E equal to 0.7 plus this is minus sign, minus. Alright, this is negative sign. 0.06 upon 6, and Sn2 positive upon copper positive the square. If you multiply this with the 3, what you get is Sn2 positive the cube and copper single positive the 6. This is what we want to find out. Now, since the cell is consumed completely, it is clearly mentioned the question that it is completely discharged. So E is equal to 0. Alright. So obviously E0, that is 0.7, is equal to 0.06 by 6. Alright. This goes here. This is alright. So what we get is 0.06 upon 6. And we have to calculate this value. So this is 0.06. This, if you solve this much portion, this is 10 raised to power minus 2. So 0.7 upon 10 raised to power minus 2 is 70. So we calculate this value. Why we are putting n is equal to 6? Because it is normally in normal reaction, if you look at the normal reaction, that is Sn plus copper single positive, that is equal to copper metal plus Sn2 positive. This is the normal formula. All right, but we want whole thrice, so both are multiplied by 3 times. Concentrations are multiplied by 3 times. This value we want to calculate. So it is 70. Correct answer is first option, question number 60. All right. Question number 61. Look at question number 61. On electrolysis of aqueous NaCl, it was observed that pH of the solution becomes 10. Which option is definitely incorrect? Definitely incorrect means 100% incorrect. So at cathode, hydrogen will be liberated. Let us see the options. Question number 61. On electrolysis of NaCl, what happens at cathode? It is H positive, which is reduced. And at anode, it is Cl negative, which is oxidized. Alright, out of OH negative and Cl negative, it is Cl negative, which is oxidized. So, which is 100% wrong is this one. That is question number 61. Moles of oxygen. The oxygen is not at all evolved. So, this is wrong. Question number 61 is definitely wrong. And in my view, question number this option number 4 is also wrong. It should be 96.5 coulombs. All right, but this is all right. This is most incorrect. This is also incorrect. It should be 96.5. Anyway, question number look at question number 62. Look at question number 62. Which of the following is pseudo first order reaction? Pseudo first order or pseudo unimolecular reaction? Both are same. Pseudo first order or pseudo unimolecular reaction. So normally hydrolysis reactions are pseudo unimolecular because water is taken in excess. All right. And in rate law, the reactant which is in excess should not be included because the change in concentration of that reactant will not affect the rate of reaction. So we have this hydrolysis reaction, that is third option. All right. Look at question number 63. We are given a reaction A is equal to B and the concentration of both reactant and product varies exponentially with time. Which of the following figures correctly describe the change in concentration of reactant and product with time? So this is an equilibrium reaction. We have only one option which is correct, that is this one. See, after some time, the concentration of reactant and product, it become constant. Alright, so we have only one option in which it become constant. See, it is increasing continuously. So this cannot be. Same here. Here there is some problem. Alright, so this is the correct one, second option. Question number 64. The colorless and paramagnetic species. In these two, we have Fe2 positive and cyanide is mentioned, so both are d2sp3 hybridized. So we don't have any unpaired electron. Here also same concept, Fe2 positive, it should be colorless and paramagnetic. Colorless, I doubt, because it should be colored and paramagnetic. All right, Fe, this one, correct answer is 64. Correct answer is first option. We have Fe3 positive. All right, Fe3 positive, so it is D5. And the type of hybridization is sp3d2. All right, so we have 5 unpaired electrons, that is why it is paramagnetic. So it should be colored. Normally paramagnetic species are colored. Rest are Fe2 positive. All right, and this one is also doubtful, because this is also Fe3 positive. Whatever is the type of hybridization, whether it is sp3d2 or d2sp3, it should be having unpaired electron, so it is paramagnetic. So but best option is this one. There is some problem in this question. All right, you can also go for third option, but second and fourth option both are having d2sp3 hybridization, and iron is in +2 oxidation state, so we don't have unpaired electrons, so both are diamagnetic. So best option is first option, 64. Question number 65, the cation which is expected to act as ligand. This is again a typical question. The point is, in thallium single positive we have S2 configuration. So S2 configuration means it can behave like electron pair, so it can behave like ligand. So it is a typical, very, don't expect such question. 65, correct answer is fourth option. Now look at 66 question. It says, which of the following reactant on reaction with concentrated NaOH followed by acidification gives the following? Lacton. This is alright. Cyclic esters are called lactones, no problem. Only as the only product. So the correct answer is third option. Actually, this is aldehyde having no alpha hydrogen. All right, this is aldehyde having no alpha hydrogen. When it is treated with concentrated NaOH, this is Cannizzaro reaction. This is Cannizzaro reaction. So one CHO group is reduced and the other one is oxidized. And now since one is acidic group and one is alcoholic group, water molecule is removed and we get this kind of compound, this kind of product. Alright. So correct answer is third option. Question number 67. This benzyl chloride is treated with KCN and then the product obtained is treated with the benzaldehyde. What is the structure of B? We have to write the structure of B. So see, when CH2Cl is treated with the CN, so this is the removal of KCl and we get C6H5CH2Cn. Now in CH2Cn we have this alpha hydrogen. All right, so this is just like aldol type of condensation. See, benzaldehyde is having a carbonyl group and this compound is having alpha hydrogen, so these two alpha hydrogens are removed, so we get this kind of product, C6H5C CN double bond C, double bond C, and C6H5H. All right, so correct answer is fourth option, 67. C6H5CH2CN double bond C6H5H. All right, question number 68. At equilibrium pressure 4 atmosphere, N2O4 dissociates 15% into NO2. At the same temperature, what will be the equilibrium pressure required for 25%? Initially it says 15%, now for 25% dissociation. So let us see question number 68. See, kp equal to 4x square p upon a minus x into a plus x. This is the reaction N2O4 that gives twice of NO2. So this is a minus x and 2x. So this is the expression for kp. Initially a is equal to 1 and x is equal to 0.15, 15%. It says p1 is 4 atmosphere. Now just put the value. This is 4x square, 4, x is 0.15, the square, pressure, initial pressure is given 4, this is 1 minus 0.15, and this is 1 plus 0.15, alright. Now Kp should remain constant, because other factors are constant, temperature is constant, so Kp should remain constant, so we have equated. Now this is equal to 4x square again, but now x is 0.25, 25%. So 4 into 0.25 the square, and this is P2, this we have to calculate now. 1 minus 0.25, 1 plus 0.25, it is 1.25. So just solve this portion, P2. When you solve, you get the correct answer, that is the fourth option we are getting. 1.38. Now look at question number 69. Alright, we will continue.